Welcome to this video on Android management and enrollment methods. First up is Android Device Administrator. This is done through a post-setup enrollment using Miradore online client and credentials. What this means is that you start up the device and then you go through the entire setup wizard, end up on the home screen, and then you could use the Google Play Store to download the Miradore online client and enroll your device. But this does, however, require you to log into the Google Play Store. If you don't want to log into the Google Play Store, you can also sideload the application, which means installing it from anywhere except from the Play Store. This, however, will give you this warning on the device telling you that it is now vulnerable, and it's perhaps something that you don't want your users to have to go through. The credentials used for this enrollment can be sent to the user via email or SMS. At this point in time, you could start managing the device. It is now enrolled and manageable from within Miradore Online. But we do not recommend this method of management. The reason being that this is an old and soon to be deprecated management method from Google, and we would rather recommend you to use Android for Enterprise, which previously was called Android for Work. Android for Enterprise consists of two different ways to manage a device, which is Work Profile and Device Owner. So let's have a look on how to enroll your device in Work Profile mode first. This is also a post-setup enrollment, so you have to go through the same steps as the previously mentioned management method. And once the device is enrolled, you can choose the device in Miradore Online, and you can then create a work profile on the device. Or, during your enrollment, you could also add the tag AFW to the device, and that will automatically create a work profile as soon as the device is enrolled. We'll have a look at exactly how work profile differs from device owner mode in just a minute. Device owner enrollment is done pre-device setup, so instead of having to go through the entire setup process, you will start from the welcome screen and either use the DPC token method, available from Android 6 and newer. This means that you will start the setup wizard, but once you get to the step where it asks you to add your Google account, instead of adding an email address here, you will type AFW hashtag Miradore, and that will start the device owner mode enrollment for this device. This does, however, require you to have enrollment credentials from Miradore Online, which none of the other device owner mode enrollments require. Next up is QR code. Starting with Android 7, once you're at the welcome screen, you can tap the welcome text 6 times. That will launch a QR code reader, which you can use to read a QR code from within Miradore Online, which then will start the enrollment process into device owner mode. And last but not least, we have Nfc enrollment, which is available from Android 5 and newer. This is by far the simplest and easiest way to get an Android device enrolled into Miradore Online. The only thing required is either to have a phone ready to beam the NFC enrollment. We have separate instructions for how to go about doing that. Or you could prepare an NFC card for enrollment. So at the welcome screen, you introduce the NFC card to the back of the phone, and that will start the enrollment process. Lastly, a few words on Samsung Knox. Samsung Knox is a layer of extra features that Samsung adds on some of their devices. It can be used with device administrator or device owner mode. It does not work with work profile. So let's have a look at the difference between work profile and device owner mode. Work profile means that the MDM will put a sandbox or a secure container on your device, and all of the company data is contained within this sandbox, and you can control whether the user can copy paste stuff from inside a container to outside of the container. It does, however, provide you with limited control outside of the sandbox. So, among the things that you can do, you can force encryption on the device, you can force them to use a passcode, you can push Wi-Fi profiles, and you can enable location tracking. But other than that, you don't have much access to actually manage the device itself. A user can unenroll and wipe the device, and if you choose to do a remote wipe of the device, it will only remove the work profile and not actually wipe the entire device, It does not support the use of Samsung Knox features, as I mentioned earlier. And the intended use for this is bring your own device. Device owner, on the other hand, gives you full control of the device. This works with Samsung Knox, and this is the intended enrollment method for company-owned devices. So, in short, if you want to have full control of the device, we recommend using device owner mode. If it's a non-company-owned device, we recommend using work profile. That was all for this video. I hope that answered some questions, and if you have any further, please don't hesitate with getting in touch with us. Have a good day.